Now we take you to the scenic Madeiras Golf Club, north of San Diego, California, where PGA Tour caddy Mark Long is going to take you inside the process he uses to create a caddy's yardage book.
When you're watching a tournament on TV, you always see the caddies pulling out this booklet, looking at it and making notes. And you ever wonder what they're looking at? Well, it's a really detailed yardage book, and it's very specialized. And I make them for the tour players and caddies on tour. We're on the 18th hole at Madeiras Golf Club north of San Diego. It's a long 600-yard par 5. It's got a lot of trouble on it. And today I'm going to give you a little inside look as to the equipment I use, the thought processes I go through to put the info in the book that the tour players need to play their best golf. This is one of the pieces of surveying equipment I use when I'm making the yardage books. It's a GPS, basically it's a GPS, piece of GPS equipment, antenna, receiver, and basically it allows me to plot points on the ground. I can tell it, okay, this is a tee box. I'm gonna walk around the tee box, and it's gonna draw it in the data for me as I'm walking around. There's probably a plate on the tee that I'm going to want to mark because I'm going to need to know the distance from this plate. I'm also going to mark the back edge of the tee because all the tour players want to know distances from here, from this one reference spot. You might have noticed the guys on the Sky Caddy commercials walking around with the backpacks. It's the exact same equipment they use. The information that I give to the tour players is also available to everybody who plays golf. That's because Sky Caddy is doing the same thing, walking out here on the ground to get it accurate, which is the only way to get it accurate. The first part of the process is just to do kind of a walkthrough of the golf course. I'm gonna look at every hole. I'm not necessarily gonna know all these distances to the bunkers and trees. I'm just gonna get a feel for the layout so I kind of know what I have to prepare for when I'm actually mapping the course. Once I'm done with my walkthrough, I'll get out my surveying equipment and I'll do a really intense mapping of the course. I'm going to walk around the outlines of every fairway, every bunker, every green. I'm going to mark trees that I think are going to come into play, water hazards. I'm going to walk the outlines of every tee. I'm going to mark every piece of irrigation that's going to come into play, all the sprinkler heads. It's a lot of work. It takes me about 25 hours and I walk, I don't even know how many miles I walk. Once I'm done with that and I've measured everything out, I'll start figuring out where a tour player's tee shots are going to tend to line to end up, and I'll start orienting the drawings to those angles. Every year I go back to check golf courses, and I'll never print another yardage book up without checking the course prior to the tournament. The caddies and players expect that from my work. There's always little changes. Maybe they move some plates on the tees. So we'll always update the courses, and fortunately that process doesn't take 70 hours every time I do it. Remember how I told you the information that is provided to the players and caddies in the yardage books are actually available to everybody who plays golf? Well, it's available through the Sky Caddy SGX. It's got a cool little feature on it called Hole View, which gives you a graphical look at what's out there in front of you. It does, not only does it do what my tour yardage book does, it actually gives you more information and it's more flexible than the yardage book. You can take this cursor and you can scroll around to anywhere on the hole. I can go to the tree over here, 256. I'll go to this tree here in the center of the fairway. It's more like 300 to that tree. Basically does exactly what my yardage book is doing for the tour pros, but it's even better. The way I can move that cursor, I can see distances to everything, whereas in the yardage book, as a caddy, I've got to walk off the back cut of the tee, I've got to do math, and I've only got a certain number of hard numbers I can actually put in the book. So here we're on an 18, the approach shot's going to be the third shot, and this is a fairly straightforward hole. So you can see where Brad's laid up. Brad doesn't lay up very often, but he had to lay up here. So Brad had to lay up here almost in the perfect spot. That's just right of where I'd set up the angle for the yardage book. The cool thing is, with the Sky Caddy, when you have IntelliGreen Pro, gives you pretty much the same graphics. You can see the mounds on the greens, you can see the false fronts, you can see the tiers. And no matter what level you're playing golf at, you know, if there is a big tear or a big spill off on the front of the green, you want to know that so you can avoid it. The cool thing the IntelliGreen Pro does that my yardage books don't do is it'll give you different angles. If I walk way over to the side here, this drawing, this graphic will actually rotate for me. I'll actually, when I'm going to make a yardage book and I think I have a hole where I'm going to have a lot of possible angles into the green, I can take the Sky Caddy out and say, okay, what's it going to look like from here? What's it going to look like from here? And it'll actually help me set up the way I can make my yardage book. So we're almost done with the process here. I've mapped everything on the course. I've gone back. I've thrown it on my laptop, oriented the drawings, measured everything out. I'll print out all that work, and I'll walk through the course again, make sure everything's in there just the way I want it. I'll tweak it a little bit, finalize it, send it to the printer. He'll do it up and ship out the books to the tournament, and the players and caddies will have something to work with next week.